Bizzibox's expert information on the female reproductive system. Do I need to know how my reproductive system works?
It's always sensible to know what your reproductive system looks like, because it helps to understand sometimes symptoms that you may get. For instance, when a woman ovulates, produces an egg, she may get pain in her tummy, and it's useful for her to know where her ovaries are so she can locate that pain. Many of the sanitary providers, such as tampons, have good little illustrations within the packets showing what the pelvis looks like. But I think it helps for people to understand the relationship between their bladder and the urethra, the pipe leading from the bladder, the vagina, which lies immediately next door to it, and behind the vagina is the rectum. All three are very, very close together. And then, of course, at the top of the vagina is the womb, the uterus, and attached to the womb are the tubes, and also attached to the womb are the ovaries.
What is the best way of understanding my reproductive system?
The best way to understand it is by looking at diagrams, so it can show you the position of all these organs inside.
What are the different external parts of the reproductive system?
What you can see on the outside are those areas covered by pubic hair, and the coverings of the vagina on the outside are called the labia, and the outer bits of the labia are called the labia majora, or the external labia, and the finer ones on the inside are the labia minora, or the inner labia, and they protect the vagina in general from infections getting in.
What are the different internal parts of the reproductive system?
Well, leading in from the labia, you have obviously the vagina and the urethra, which is the pipe from the bladder lying immediately above the vagina. And above the urethra is the clitoris, which is the female equivalent to the penis. Obviously, it's considerably smaller, but it is very, very sensitive. And it gives rise, obviously, when manipulated, to sexual pleasure. The vagina itself varies according to whether a woman has had a baby or not, and whether she's pre- or postmenopausal. But in general, it's about 4 to 5 inches long, and at the top of it sits the neck of the womb, the cervix. Now, internally, that means inside the pelvis, there is the rest of the womb, the body of the uterus, and that obviously contains the lining of the womb from which periods arise, and which also carry a pregnancy. For pregnancy to get in there, the egg has to be fertilized and travel along what are called the fallopian tubes, and they're attached to the top of the womb, one on each side. And at the end of the fallopian tubes, there are the ovaries, and these are the organs that produce the eggs.
Are all females' genitalia shaped the same?
There's a huge variation in the shapes and sizes of the labia. The inner ones, the labia minora, can be very large indeed for some women, and in others very small. And I am certainly aware that quite a lot of women find the size of their labia embarrassing, particularly if they're wearing a tight bikini at other times. And they can be plastically reduced in size if they find it very difficult to cope with.
www.bizzibox.com